2,000 people, the survivors of the Boston Blast. Coming back, Peter Matthews and Wall Street, the reaction to the Boston bombing.
Here we go.
KTLK, AM 1150, your voice. I'm David Cruz. You know, we've been looking at different aspects. What does something like this do when Wall Street gets the shakes? How is this going to affect us right now and in the near future, I think. Because I'm glad that they're getting a handle on these two suspects, because there's nothing that makes people more tense than the unknown. And that's what you don't want. That's what the president was talking about today. Not to be living as though you're teetering, but to live purposefully and to move past this. So I've invited Peter Matthews, our political analyst, Professor Peter Matthews. Hey, Peter, thank you for making time.
Hello, Dave. I'm right here with you. Good to hear from you.
Well, thank you. And we wanted to reach out to you because I make that link between an incident like this, an attack like this, and how quirky Wall Street and investors can be. And there is a ripple effect that comes into play. So tell me what you're seeing and what you're hearing.
What I'm seeing and hearing is that, of course, this is much different than the effects during the New York attack, the attack at the World Trade Center, because over there they disrupted the actual financial trading system. You know, stock market itself was hit. You know, World Trade Center, a lot of the trading people were in the center itself. And in Boston, it was certainly civilians, three civilians that were killed, but it wasn't a disruption of the whole financial trading system. So what you're seeing is I saw some volatility, Dave. That's the main thing about Boston.
Right.
You know, it went up, the stock market went down by 1.8% on Monday, but it went up on Tuesday by 1.1%, Wednesday down again by 1%, and down today by 0.5%. That's volatility, unpredictability, because people didn't know exactly what happened, you know. That's the major difference in the two areas.
Yeah, and you know, when the first reports came out, you know how the New York Post put out a story that identified a Saudi national as a suspect. At that point, I said, oops. Here we go, and that's going to throw the energy markets on their ear or whatever, off balance.
Yeah.
So, do you think it's good that they're able to now start to home in on a couple of guys and people start to get a sense that this indeed is under control?
Absolutely, because what the stock market and any economic growth needs is stability. And once you get a handle on this thing, people are settling down a bit more and saying, now we know what's going on. It's not an international attack where the oil supply is going to be threatened, you know. And there are different kinds of terrorist attacks. Attacks on the energy sector is one. Attacks on individual companies. Mm-hmm. Attacks on the financial sector, which we saw in New York, which was the worst kind. And also massive attacks that continue. And that's the Boston one was neither of those. So none of those, actually. So it is a good thing they're getting a handle on what this could be, who the causes of this are. And that'll bring stability in the economy once more, in the stock market as well. Will settle down. Don't forget, Dave, there's also other reasons why the stock market has been going down as well recently and not doing so well. That's the United States economy itself, the slow growth, and the European countries, the problems in Greece and other countries there, as well as the lack of growth in China. All those things have had a dampening effect on the stock market, not just this attack in Boston.
You know, and there's the other thing that I was also hearing about this week, and I was meaning to talk to you about it. Gold has gone into a meltdown. The price of gold has tanked. I mean, it's coming down, not up. I mean, it went up beautifully for people who got in early. But again, all of these factors converging, of course, and thank God that the scale of the Boston attack has not been larger than it was, though three people being killed and many, many more being wounded, some critically, is nothing to ignore. But I'm just glad, as you say, it wasn't
something. We've got to pray for those folks and their families. We've got to keep them in prayer and in remembrance for sure. It could have been a lot worse.
So now we talk in a little bit broader sense, and maybe you can help me with this. You know, we've been talking with first responders today about the psyche, because I am talking psyche. I'm talking political psyche here. As people go into the weekend here, day after tomorrow, we've got this huge cycling event in Los Angeles. Of course, we've got all kinds of other activities around the city.
At the Grand Prix.
Exactly.
Grand Prix in Long Beach.
Yeah, so we've got all of these things going on. All right, do you see continued shakiness or, you know, the nervousness of a cat? Or do you think that we tough it out and we, in fact, get back out there and enjoy life?
I think Americans are very resilient. They'll go back out there and enjoy life. There'll be a few people that won't show up at those events because they're afraid of what could happen. But as we get a handle on who these suspects are, and it appears it's not as continuous all over the country, then we're going to be much more secure, and more people will go to these events. So I don't see a big drop-off this weekend in either Long Beach or in L.A., but we'll see what happens as we go along.
I'll tell you something, Peter. I just hope and I pray that there is not anything more that happens like this. I mean, the blast in Texas only added to the skittishness. It's been kind of a skittish week. That's, you know, I talk to a lot of people during the day. I don't know if you're encountering the same thing. People are asking me, don't you have anything other than gloomy news to talk about? I mean, does the political cycle, I mean, even the immigration thing kind of got put on a back burner, but does the political cycle feel the reverberation of these kinds of incidents, you know, from where you stand in the academic, you know?
Absolutely. In fact, in my political science classes, my U.S. government class today, we were talking about not only what happened in Boston, but Texas, but also this gun control issue, which got defeated in the Senate because of a horrible, you know, rule about a filibuster needing 60 votes.
Right.
All of this is keeping people on edge as far as politics. We're also interested in what's going on in the world. You know, it's tragic it has to take this kind of thing, but hopefully people will keep the interest going in politics and, you know, seek to use it to build a better world. That's what it should be all about, politics. It's about building a better world, Dave.
Well, here we go. The final statement by the chief investment strategist from McGraw-Hill on Wall Street said today, until the passage of time, as well as the reports from police calm nerves, then people, including investors, are definitely going to be on edge. Well, Dr. Professor Peter
right
Matthews,
on.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you, my brother, for talking to us. Have a great rest of the week, and we'll talk to you next week.
You bet, brother. You bet. Stay safe.
All right. I appreciate it. All right. Professor Peter Matthews, Cypress College. I always like to reach out to him because he brings an interesting perspective. And indeed, this is a week when, in addition to the news events that I've been sharing with you,